The exact replicas of the ones mobs say yes, they absolutely were. Over to Caesar's Palace, maybe over to the Bellagio or back over here to Bally's. It'll also get you very close to Treasure Island and the Mirage. But our next stop over at, now tucked in the back there, we have the beautiful Aria Hotel. And straight in front of us here, we have the Cosmopolitan. Now you're going to notice that our Cosmopolitan has balconies on all of its floors. Now if you look around, there's no other hotel on the strip that's going to give you that luxury. The Cosmopolitan was actually originally supposed to be another set of high-rise condos. But when their investors backed out, they went through the court system and had to jump through a couple of hoops. As we can, so I put in the fake grass. Now on several occasions I've seen Stephen's gardeners out there vacuuming the grass, trying to get all the pine needles up, because he really is just that sticky. He is at the link. We have the blue sign for the link, and underneath is the orange sign for Batista's Italian restaurant. Now Batista's is one of the few places that those mob guys used to hang out at. What's in the middle looks like it slices the building in half is the Mandarin Oriental. The top half is high-rise condos, and the bottom half is their hotel. They went 50-50 with it. Now the two towers next to it that appear to be leaning, well, no, your eyes are not playing tricks on you. They are leaning. Those are the Veer Towers. They veer to the left and to the right. They are completely residential. The bottom floor condos sold for $300,000 a piece. And those top floor condos went for three.
They should have 20 minutes before that night will leave. We're only about 10
minutes. Now, swinging here to our stop, see if there's anyone new to join us before we head on back over to Circus Circuits. Now, the bushes, the trees, and the flowers here went around 100% real. Just the grass that is totally fake. So they got rid of Bugsy, but they do have a nice memorial for him inside. Now this end of Flamingo Hotel, they've added the Jimmy Buffett's Margaritaville. In October of 2011, our Margaritaville made their way into the Guinness Book of World Records with the world's largest frozen margarita. It was in a 14-foot tall glass that they had sitting out front. They had to fill it from the balcony. Now it took 6,000 bottles of triple sec and 6,000 bottles of tequila. It took two long weeks to get everything all stirred up and frosted, but when it was finally finished. Now as you get up here, we go past the sign. Don't worry about trying to get a photo of the front of the sign as we go down this way, because you're gonna be turned around awkwardly in your chair and you'll have little solar panel trees in your view that completely block the shot. But don't worry. We're going to go past the sign. We will U-turn to come back down facing it. And as we do, Misael goes nice and slow so that everybody can get a good picture of the sign from the bus. So no worries, we got you covered. Now coming up off to our left here, we're going to see our McCarran Airport. A lot of people don't know this.